Bung, bung, bung. Oh, we've got a much better assault rifle. Raptor 5. Anti-personnel rounds. 3. That's all I've got, really. Okay. Recoil dampener, I like that on this. Any armor? Oh, okay, I do have armor now. Duelist 4, I will take that. Yes, please. Oh, damn, look at that! I don't ever remember an armor like that. I want hardening, please. Because I'm very good at that in real life.
We've got to get in there before they execute the chairman.
Well, geez, they're not exactly making it hard. I'll search this place for loot after we've, cleared this place out.
See how it is?
Were they T-posing?
You write letters and everyone ignores you. Force is the only thing people appreciate. So how about if I kill Chairman Burns and finish the charade?
Please, I was trying to help you people.
Let's not do anything we're all gonna regret.
Why not? What have we got to lose? Since the chairman here decided that we didn't get reparations, we've got nothing left to live for.
But I've changed my mind. Seeing you all, it's clear that you all deserve...
You had your chance. Some L2s are nearly crippled from side effects of the implants, but you voted against reparations.
If you die fighting, you'll get a lot of biotics killed as well.
What do you mean?
If people think that all L2 biotics are violent extremists, what is that going to accomplish?
But people need to hear about what the government has done and what it has failed to do.
People have already heard. You don't have to kill me to make your point.
You're right. I don't want to die. Maybe something will happen this time. We surrender.
Thank you, Commander. I thought I was dead when they took me. I'll see to it that the reparations discussion is reopened. I didn't know they were so desperate.
A 5th Fleet cruiser will be by shortly to pick you and the prisoners up.
So we're just gonna leave them on the ship alone, just him and the quote-unquote prisoners that are fully armed.
Thank you, Commander. I thought I was dead when they took me.
You are very welcome, sir. Oh, is that space squid still out there? Don't know. Yep, see right here is one of those places where you can get on top of something. This is weird and very particular whenever you can actually do that. Well, that was clearly a mission, and it's still not, I feel like we've done more than 5 with Ashley now. guess not. Let me just make sure that we've not gotten an achievement that I didn't notice pop up. Nope, it's still just land on it. Excuse me.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
Thank you for dealing with the hostage situation, Commander. Chairman Burns was quite impressed by the way you resolved the situation peacefully. Your assistance above and beyond the formal duties has been noted, Commander. Fifth Fleet out.
There's the Han system that we need to go to, so let's check the Ming system first. Once one of my squad mates, I get that achievement.
Commander, urgent message from Alliance Command coming in. I'll patch it through.
Uh-oh.
Shepard, this is Admiral Hackett from Alliance Command. We've got a situation here, and you're the only one that can handle it.
What do you need, Admiral?
There's an Alliance training ground where we test weapons and technology and live fire simulations. One of the VIs we use to simulate enemy tactics in the drills is no longer responding to our override commands. It's gone rogue.
Are you telling me this computer is thinking on its own?
We're not stupid, Shepard. This is a virtual intelligence, not a true AI. It's not self-aware, and it can't access any external systems. We didn't do anything illegal here. Virtual intelligence support is critical to our military success. VIs process thousands of status reports and react in nanoseconds. No human can do that. We need you to fight your way through the training ground of the VI Corps and manually disable it.
Can't you disable it remotely?
Our failsafes aren't responding. The VI operates on a closed network. It can't affect any external systems, but we don't have any direct access to its processes.
Well then.
We could bomb it from orbit, but the damage to the facility would be catastrophic. We'd prefer to have someone shut down the core. Someone like you. I know Spectre's answered the Council, but you're still human. You're still part of the Alliance military, and right now we need you. The VI controls all the facility's weapons, drones, and automated defenses. You're the only one that can pull this off, Shepard. Good luck.
Some pointless fail-safes if they don't even work. Medallion recovered. Nothing. Titanium. This must be in the other system, because there's the MSB Worthington here, which is a destroyed, damaged vessel, it looks like. I don't think this has anything to do with the training ground one. Oh, is this the one that jump scared me in the original LP? Does anybody remember there was
guess a... nobody's home.
Most of the systems are shut down. It's just running on basic life support.
There was a vessel in the original LP I did where I got jump scared and screamed. This might be the one.
Hear that? We're not alone. Somebody set that trap. The whole place could be wired.
Okay, this isn't the one, I don't think.
say Jacob's gone. They say his brain isn't functioning anymore, and they want to shut off his machines. But Jacob's the only thing in the world that matters to me. I don't know how to help him, and it's tearing me up inside. I just feel so helpless, so damn angry. Dr. Smith gave me some meds to calm down, but I didn't take them. I can't. Not until I figure out a way to help Jacob. I won't give up on him. I won't!
Jacob's not going to make it. His brain was deprived of oxygen for too long. There's nothing any of us can do for him now except let him die with dignity. It's what he would want. I'm more worried about Julia now. She's showing signs of severe depression. I gave her some meds that should help, but I better warn the captain.
Looks like that machine is keeping him alive.
I'm not seeing any brain activity on the readouts. He's dead. This body is just an empty shell.
Maybe we should shut the machine down. It's the merciful thing to do.
It's your decision, Shepard. But maybe we should wait until we know more about what's going on before we do anything.
The lighting on Tali makes her look far darker in color, like her uniform, her outfit, or her suit, I mean. It used to be very vibrantly purple.
Jacob is showing no signs of brain activity. There's nothing more we can do for him. He wouldn't want to be kept alive by machines, so we're going to disconnect the life support. Dr. Smith is worried about Julia's reaction, though. She can't seem to let Jacob go. The stress is making her implants flare up, causing intense migraines. It'll probably be easier for everyone if we don't tell her until after we shut the life support down. Give her a chance to...
Julia, what are you doing here? Why are you...
Speaking of Captain Bannon, that's another game that I did two LPs on, World in Conflict. Oh, shit! Well, that was a quest thing.
You did the right thing, Commander.
Poofty.
And out we get. We have other systems to explore. One other system at least here.
This is going by pretty well so far. It's almost 10 a.m. now. I almost feel like we could beat the game today. No. No. There's no way. Is there? No. I'll decide tomorrow if I'm gonna get that shot or not now, or if I'm gonna wait. Light metal, beryllium. It's bringing me back to Mass Effect Andromeda. That's the planet we can land on, and it's a cold hazard. Three cold planets in a row. I almost thought that said Palavin. Matriarch's writings discovered. Anyways, I was saying earlier before dialogue cut me off, Once we get the achievement for one of these characters, I'm gonna go and get Liara, do a story mission there, and then put her in our squad. And then when the other one gets finished, I'll put one of my main squad members in that I want for this playthrough. Okay. Let's just travel forward. This place is very stormy. Syndicate hideout. So this is the other... Well, then what... What was that? No. Wait, did we level up? We must have leveled up at some point. So what was, Oh, it's in the Sol system. Right, I thought it was on the moon. I thought we got it because it was in... because it was in the system we were going to explore, but I guess it was just a random happening thing. Okay. So I suppose that's acceptable. Cobalt. It's a game I've never played. Come on! You peen. Oh, actually, that's the corner of the map right there, I think. This isn't the only snowy planet we'll be exploring either. This isn't the last one, I guess I should say. That would make more sense. This is more mountainous than the other ones. Okay, we got an anomalous and an ore. Mummified Solarian. Well, he seems to be in a box. ID tag recovered.
Ready.
Presumably, doing this syndicate mission will lead to unlocking Helena's location, which in turn will bring us to the end of that quest line, hopefully. Well, this base seems well defended. It's got the height advantage, it's got turrets. See if there's an actual way to get up there. I think it's the game that's having the stutter issue, because the snow effects actually judder around whenever the game stutters, which just makes it feel like it's a game thing and not just the PC having struggles, but I could be wrong. There's another level up, too. And Garrus is gonna get real freaking powerful once we bring him back into the squad. Hello? What the fuck? Oh god, I can't enter anything. What? I can't do anything. Like, I can't even bring up my weapons and stuff. Well, what? Dude, it's gonna kill me. I can't do anything. I can't even bring up my inventory. Like, none of the stuff's working. I can't sprint. I can't interact with anything. Can I leave? I can't leave. I can't save either. Because why would it let you save when you're in the middle of dying? What the hell is this shit? Game? Well, that was a bit fucking shit. What was my last save? When we landed here. Great. Now I get to do the whole fucking planet again. That's a bit stupid. I don't know what happened there. Some bug, obviously. But... oh well, shit happens, I guess. I kept saying inventory, but I meant I couldn't bring up, like, the squad menu UI where you can change your weapon and order people around and stuff. It wouldn't let me even bring up that menu. Allow me to go through this again real quick. Shouldn't be that bad. Just a minor setback. I'll start quick saving a little bit more often. I might have to do it like Fallout style where I quick save every 3 seconds. Oh, I actually took damage there. Are you fucking kidding me? Okay, at least I can return to Normandy if I need to. Come on. Come on. Come on, you know you want to flip over. You've gotta be fucking kidding me. Come on, please. Come on, yes, get your wheels, just get them on the ground a little bit. No, what are you doing? That doesn't make any sense. Come on. Just, yes, get your wheels stuck.
Get your, just your wheels have to touch. That's all you gotta do. Come on. You can do this. Yes!
Yes!
This place is destined to get me fucked, apparently. And that's my headset. This way this time. I should actually stop the recording at some point today, like maybe when I go to have an actual proper meal, you know, and actually feed myself like humans should be doing. I might, I'll take that time to start uploading some episodes. Processing and uploading them, that way I can start freeing up a little bit more inventory. I almost called my computer storage inventory room. God damn it. I'm not gonna level up yet because I don't know what fucked everything up. I saved it this time. Let me out. Oh my god, it worked. Okay. Now I will put points into... I don't even remember what I... What did I put my points into? I don't remember what I put my point... Well, apparently they all have shitloads of points now. What? I could have swore before they had 1 point each. Okay, I don't know. Then I guess I'll put multiple points into stuff then. So you can have that. This is the last base, so there's gonna be shits in here who wanna get fucked. Or should I say there's shits in here that are going to get fucked? Oh lord. Oh shit. Come on, little shit. Second crime lord defeated. That's both of them. No doubt Helena Blake will be overjoyed to learn that these two scum are no longer a problem. Okay, so now I must meet with Helena Blake in the Horsehead Nebula. So we gotta go back to there. And Rogue VI is still there. Okay. shall find out what my spoils of war are. Some loot. Those guys were pushovers compared to the last place. Then again, we did level up in between, but still. My crotch itches. What do I do about that? I don't want to... Oh, okay. Okay, so we now need to finish exploring the place. Oh, we... Which way are we going? This way. What the fuck was it? Did you see that? What was that? I don't know, but something popped up on the screen for half a second. Now my mind is going wild with imagination of just... of it being like a horror image of some dead animal or something. That's an open-ass area. You know, it is May, which I think is one of the presumed dates that Far Cry 6 was supposed to be releasing. I'll need to look into that, because it had a release date, and then the release date just disappeared, presumably because of COVID. And I don't think it has, or it hasn't had a release date for a while. So I was really interested in that, and then it went dark. And now, of course, Ubisoft has announced that they're planning to focus on making free-to-play titles for all of their major IPs, which is just fucking great. Doesn't help anyways that Far Cry 6 isn't coming out on Steam anyways, at least not right away. I said anyways twice, by the way. But that doesn't mean... Is there really nothing else here? I'm going to check the middle. That doesn't really mean much because... The previous Assassin's Creed also hasn't been added to Steam yet, and that's been out for a while now. From what I can tell, it looks like we have finished this place. Nope. Okay, I was right. There is more on this planet.